Good afternoon, everybody, and thanks for joining us here on the web. It is primary day in New Hampshire. We're told that voter turnout has been pretty light so far, as expected. There are dozens of races on the ballot today. We'll be closely following four big Republican primaries. There are three major contenders in the U.S. Senate Republican primary. Scott Brown, Jim Rubens, and Bob Smith are all looking to race against Jeanne Shaheen in November. Walt Havenstein and Andrew Hemingway are looking to challenge Governor Maggie Hassan. In the congressional races, Frank Ginta is facing Dan Innes in the 1st District. And in the 2nd District, it's Marilinda Garcia versus Gary Lambert and Jim Lawrence. Ray Brewer was at the polls this morning and spoke with voters.
Primary day in New Hampshire.
Okay, the polls of Ward 9 are officially open.
In the state's largest city, the polls opened at 6, but there were only a few voters lined up to get their ballots. The Secretary of State is predicting a turnout of about 20% of the voters, but the moderator in Ward 9 doubts they'll reach that number. In neighboring Goffstown, a similar situation. Jack and Priscilla Valancourt did make the trek to the polls. The race is most important to him.
Senator, first thing, and also the governor. Yes, so we need to change things around a little bit.
As for the number one issue,
economy, jobs. My son's been out of work for several months now, so this is truly very deep in my heart.
In New Boston, there are about 3,500 registered voters. The moderator thinks turnout will only be about 10%. But here also, the economy seems to be on voters' minds.
I need job creation, and I hate to see jobs leaving our country.
And another issue is the need for change.
I just think that the government has become too big and too much into our pockets, and I'm not happy about it.
The gubernatorial and congressional races have drawn most of the attention, but Scott Nato came out to support the current county attorney. Nato admits he needs to do a little more studying before casting his ballot in the November election.
I don't feel that I'm educated enough about who's running, and I feel it's important, so I need to be more educated, before the general election.
The Secretary of State's office predicts a low voter turnout at just 20% for today's election, but those who do plan to vote will do so under the state's new voter ID law. The types of IDs that will work are government-issued IDs like a driver's license, armed services ID, or a student ID from high school or college. You can still vote without an ID, but you will be asked to sign documents swearing that you are who you say you are, and the ballot will be set aside for confirmation. Dover police are investigating a number of home burglaries. Early this morning on Cassily Lane alone, there were two break-ins and three other attempted break-ins. One homeowner confronted the intruder with a gun around 2 this morning. He ran off, and that's when police discovered the other victims. Investigators say in both cases, he entered the home through unlocked windows or doors and was looking for cash. U.S. officials believe they have identified the masked terrorist who beheaded New Hampshire native James Foley. The terrorist group ISIS posted a video of Foley's killing last month. Authorities focused on British nationals who joined the terror group after hearing the killer's accent. The FBI says they worked with British officials to identify the militant. They are not releasing his name because of the ongoing investigation. Also today, new details about the killing of 2nd American journalist by ISIS terrorists. A spokesman for Stephen Sotloff's family says terrorists paid rebels to alert them when Sotloff entered Syria. The family says it learned from, quote, sources on the ground that Sotloff's whereabouts were sold for between $25,000 and $50,000. Meantime, today, Kimball Union Academy, where he graduated from, is announcing a scholarship fund in his name. We'll stay with News 9 on this primary day for complete election coverage. We will have live team coverage starting with News 9 at 5 and 6 and then continuing special election broadcasts at 8, 9 and 10 p.m. leading up to News 9 at 11. And of course, you can keep track of all the developments all day long here on our website, WMUR.com. That does it for us. Have a great afternoon, everybody.